This is going to be home for the next few days.
Sounds great.
There's a mung, bro!
Yeah, the mangere, classic vintage. I knew that would be the go-to bomb.
Well, while we're travelling, we've got some skippy lures out to catch some bait and some marlin lures, because while we're travelling across this ocean, we might catch some marlin. And speaking of which, have you ever caught one?
Never caught a marlin, Matt.
How about a big kingfish? Would you like to catch one of those?
I'd love to catch a blue kingy, Matt.
How about a blue nose, a bass or a harp hooker?
Never caught any of those, so it's on my to-do list.
Well, it is a good thing, because where we're going, all of the aforementioned fish are a very real proposition, because where we're heading is the Ramfurly Banks. So what is your biggest kingy?
Just under 25 kilos.
Oh, mean. Oh, no, that's epic.
Even just a pocket, mate. Like, I know it's probably not the most exciting fish to catch, but...
I think heaps of kiwis, it's like, pocket's one of those, they're such good eating.
I suppose it's just probably because I've never had the opportunity to, you know, to go out so far, really. Like, all our fishing's only ever done from small boats sort of thing, you know.
Oh, well, hopefully we can tick a few boxes.
Yeah, if I can beat my PB King, I'll be pretty happy.
Mate, they fixed my mate up the other day. If you're a little bit suspect, just take a couple. My kids take them. My girl's all right, but my boy gets a bit seasick.
So take a couple.
You're over 12 years old, eh? You'll be right with two then.
A lot of gannets and then on the surface up here, so
what is it?
A bit of a workout, mate. Got some gannets going on in front of us, so go have a little bit of a look over there and see what's under them. Might be a monster.
Well, once upon a time, when you're out of Whakatane and you saw dolphins like this, you would literally expect all of your lures to go off hooking up with yellowfin tuna that are known to run with the dolphins. However, there's still plenty of dolphins in the ocean, there's just no yellowfin tuna left. What a shame. Yep, there he goes. Just a little Williamson feather jig. It's pretty hard to beat those little Williamson lures.
Nice big fatty too.
There you go. Caught one of those before?
Huh?
Well, stand closer to the bungee line, mate. You might get a catch one.
Yo, got him on.
Oh yeah, first tuna. How was that experience for you? Well, hopefully we'll be feeding those whole to another fish that you might be able to catch. That'll be a new experience for you.
Yep.
Yep, got him on. Oh, got him on over here too. Beautiful baits.
Beautiful.
Now the whole idea of the bungee is that we don't have to slow down. You can imagine if we had to stop for every single one of those tuna, we'd never get there. But instead we're just... Oh! We're just hauling them in, just like this. Just a neat little fish. Skipjack tuna. That's primo, eh? Even with all these tuna, we still needed more bait. So we fished through the night for some jack mackerel and netted a few flying fish.
He's in there.
That is a great bait. We even managed a couple of hours sleep before continuing on to the Ramfurly Bank. Well, en route to the Ramfurly Bank this morning, on the Fruno, we've come across a bit of foul, a bit of a hill. It's got some marks on it. So we've decided that it's time for Bevan to catch his first harp hooker, or first bass, or first blue nose. So this is the rig here, mate.
Wicked.
Circle hook. You just want to be keeping that sinker in touch with the bottom. But when it hits, wind tight. You don't want to let the line go slack and let these hooks dangle down and tangle up on the coral or anything. And also that sinker banging on the bottom like that, it also wakes up the old bass that's sleeping in his hole. It does a bit of noise, I think helps, because it's really dark down there. There you go, you're away. Free support all the way down. 200 metres.
200 metres. Bring it on.
Right. You know, Bevan,
yep.
The trick is when you start getting bites, don't do the big strike.
Yeah.
Super hooks, mate.
Hello, getting bites straight away, mate. Oh, yep. Here you go, hey. Ah, bugger, I'll wind him in. So now this is where the real hard graft begins, you know? This is where you really earn your feed of fish when you're pukka fishing.
Oh yeah.
It's really starting to fight now.
Be nice for the old mate, Bevan, to get one though. Nothing like a first fish. And a harpooker is a pretty special one if you've never caught one before.
Hey, seriously, you've never fished here before, Mike? Just came across a bit of sign? I love that.
First fish in a new spot, I love it.
And it's a genuine pukka, and he took the live bait, eh? We're staying up to 3:30 in the morning catching them puppies then, by the looks. Oh, yes. What did I say? I'd be happy with about a 12 kg pukka would be perfect for me. Perfect size. Oh, better than I thought, actually.
Yeah, beautiful. Well done, Matty.
Sweet, mate.
We're on the board, mate. We're on the board.
There's nothing like some runs on the board. One of those to start with.
Righto, boys. Bit of sign down here. Let him go, eh?
Oh, there you go, Mike.
There you go, mate.
Watch that big strike, feather chucker.
Getting bites here, mate?
I think so. Oh,
Bevan's getting bites.
There he goes.
Got him?
Yeah, mate.
Yeah, there you go.
Good stuff.
Oh, yep, that was a bite. Oh, bait's getting harassed, my bait.
Crank him up, mate. Get him off the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, he's pulling line.
Oh, yep. Here you go, hey. Uh-oh. I'm not getting anywhere. Oh, we're all hooked up. We're not even at the red filling yet. I've got to get this into the rod holder. This is too hard. Oh, no. Right, go and check on these fellas.
A little bit of colour coming up here, mate.
Oh yeah, there he goes.
Right here.
I'm happy, bro. Sweet as.
It's a nice eater there, Mike.
Beautiful.
I thought just while I'm fighting my harpooka, or I don't know exactly what it is that I'm hooked up to, so I'll just come down and see, be part of this meritorious occasion. Bevan's first pukka, potentially. Or perhaps shark. What do you reckon? I mean, if these turn out to be pukkas, they'll probably be looking pretty good.
Yeah, definitely, mate. We've got a couple on board now, so we'll go and chase some kingies and see if we can take a few more boxes for Bevan here. See if we can bend him over the rail with the big kingfish.
I'm glad you qualified that with big kingfish.
I was starting to get a bit worried, eh?
What have we got? What have we got? Oh, it's a kingfish! What do you say about going kingy fishing, Mike? Found this new kingy spot, bro. There you go, that is over 200 metres down. The other day, we were catching them in 2 or 3 metres of water, right up in the shallows. Well, there you go. From 220 odd metres down, and hopefully we'll be seeing plenty more of these. Bigger ones. Oh, look at that, he's smoking them.
That's the good thing about these kingfish, eh, Matty? Pretty hardy, 220 metres, mate. In the water and she's gone.
Pretty remarkable, you know, yeah. Like all of that barometric change, the pressure change that it's going through, and they can handle it, you know, and just see that fish just powered away. Uh-oh. And still, a little boy waits. Now, these can be a bit of a bugger to deal with. I mean, what would you do, you know, if you just come out here and caught one straight off the bat? You'd be drunk by now.
They're actually not bad eating, these, Grey boys.
Grey boy, that's what they call them down south, eh?
Yep.
Or tope shark, school shark. Yeah, well, there's a commercial industry for them. So we might just slide them on back so our commercial brothers can catch them and make a bit of money. Well, I reckon with those sharks showing up, it might be best to move on for a kingy.
Think so, mate.
You might just have to wait a wee bit, Bevan.
That's alright, eh? It's fishing.
Fish on the sounder there. Then we've got to look around, see if we can hook one.
Now we've decided that we're going to start Bevan off fishing for kingfish with the old favourite jig, the Williamson Benthos 300 gram. Now you've never done any mechanical jigging before?
Haven't done any mechanical jigging,
right. It's not as tricky as it looks. So we're just going to drop that down. We've got some rainbow braid on there that changes colours every 10 metres.
Oh,
So that way, see, we're on our 20th meter now. Okay, so I've gotten down just past 30. I'm just gonna jig that back up, and there you go, and you hook up just like that. And that's how you hook a kingfish on a jig.
So apparently, that, eh?
Yeah. Unfortunately, I didn't get long to show you the technique. Damn, ran fairly. Now that's just one of the things you got to deal with kingfish, particularly jigging. There's small fish there, you've got to weed your way through them, and the big ones are going to come along. Okay, have a go at that, eh? Yeah, that's it, that's it. Almost. You'll get there, but you've got a kingy on, you've got to deal with it.
Yeah, I found him at the first couple
yeah,
of
Yeah, I know. Can be a problem. So, well, there's these rats here, it'll give you good practice before we perhaps move on to somewhere where there's some bigger ones.
Yep.
Little rats hassling my live bait at the moment. There you go, tighten up if you have to, tighten up, tighten up. Put your thumb on the spool, put your thumb on the spool. That's a real one, mate. Go forward, follow your fish, I'll come with you. Upset the fish's swimming pattern, mate, by using the rod. Short stroke, that's 80 pound gear, that's strong as gear. Oh, mate.
Is it fell off the swimming or is he in the ground?
Are you moving him? Move him. Are you moving him? Move him.
Yeah, we're moving.
Moving
this way now.
Yeah, we've got him moving this way now.
There you go,
what
are we saying?
There you go, what are we saying? Little rat kingfish, little rat kingfish. This is hopefully everything holds together.
Oh,
that's a real problem, mate. What do you think of mechanical jigging so far?
Bro, this is awesome.
It works.
Yew!
I mean, this is your typical Ramfurly weather, really, and that's why there's so many fish here, because if it was beautiful, flat, calm seas and nicely accessible, I'm sure there wouldn't be so many fish here. The Cascade's a great bait, though. We're probably up over 25 knots of breeze now, and it's still well fishable.
Start working your way back, mate. Just keep winding as you go, keep winding as you go. Oh, just maybe back off a little bit now. Now, while that rod there looks light, and it's got a heck of a bend in it, that is a Shimano Blue Rose jig rod. It is designed for 80 pound tackles. So to give you some idea, this thin braid here, the Suffolk Rainbow braid, is as heavy as the monofilament that's on those big game fishing reels up there. So we're talking about some serious strain going on here. Isn't that right?
Oh, it certainly is, mate.
Now, the important thing too is with the old jig, that hook can be tearing a hole.
Yeah.
And because the jig's heavy, if he shakes his head, the hook can come out. So you just gotta keep everything nice and tight. Boat rocking up and down, use it to your advantage. Get another one. No, we're okay for now.
Oh!
Run to ground. That was a donkey, bro.
Bro.
That was not your 25 kilo one nor your 30 kilo one. That was your bigger again.
So far, Bevan has struck out on his pooker and now lost a big kingfish.
That was a trip maker right there.
It's a hard lesson learned, but fortunately, we've got plenty of time to turn it around. And let's not forget, we're at the Ramfurly Banks.
No worries, Bev, we'll get you one, mate. We'll see you're right. Right. Now, hopefully, that'll be a bit much of a mouthful for those smaller kingfish. Oh, bait's getting harassed, my bait. Yeah, I've been bit. I've been bit on that big bait.
Nah,
just a greedy bloody rat. A greedy rat's eating our biggest live bait. Oh, slightly better than a rat, maybe. I take it back, it's not a rat. It's always thick and fast out here at the Ramfurly. No complaints there. Just roll them over then. That's a little bit better. Oh, he's a fatty. Here he goes, thank you, mate. It's like a constant state of being hooked up here. And it's just a case of fishing till you can't fish anymore. And along the way, you're gonna get some real beauties. And I'm just sort of letting my bait down. And they seem to be up at about that 40 meter mark. Okay, my bait's been picked up now. It's slowly increasing that drag. Move to my gimbal bout, that circle hook should be rolling into the corner of the mouth.
Oh.
And we're hooked up. And this gear here, definitely overkill for the size of the kingfish I've got on at the moment.
but you never know when that 30 kilo plus one's gonna come along. Not better than what I thought it was. There you go, thanks mate. Maybe a little bit better than the last. Oh, look at his tail. That guy there, at some stage in his life, has had an encounter with a shark. We were just talking about how hardy these kingies were, eh, Mike? And look at this, he's had an encounter with a shark. We were just talking about how hardy these kingies were. He's a tough bugger, we want him in the gene pool, so let's get him back out there, eh, mate? Oh, yeah, I'm bit. It's just instant. These guys, look, double hook up on the jigs. Live bait's getting bitten as soon as it goes down. Okay, you're underneath me, mate. You're underneath me. Come this way. Follow your fish down, mate. The ram pearly shark. Oh, is that a better one? Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Another kingy, feisty little bigger. We've been fishing not 30 minutes, and we're probably up to 10, 12 kingfish. Gosh, I don't know. We're going to lose count real quick here. Well, a little bit of rat kingfish avoidance. Nice big old flying fish. I'd eat it if I was a big kingy. Now with this big flying fish being dead, of course it's nice to put a little bit of action into it because of course we know how well the jigs work, how well the live bait works. It triggers that attack instinct. But of course, I've got a circle hook in there, so it's not like hooking up on a jig. So what I do is I put on just enough drag that I can wind line. And I lift the rod and wind, lift the rod and wind. And as I do that, I'm clamping down with my thumbs on the spool. Just enough to get me a little wind each time. Now, when that gets grabbed, I can just stop winding, let go, and that line will run out and allow that great big flying fish to be swallowed by a kingfish. It's like dead bait jigging. Here we go. And, oh, I think I just had a nudge. Then let it go again. Back to free spool, and he's grabbed it again. Obviously, he's not quite up to the size to eat that big flying fish. Slowly increase the drag pressure. And, oh, got him. Oh, yes. There you go. Holy smokes. Woohoo! Just woke up when he saw the boat there. Oh, yep, they're getting better. I just float him in on a wave. Here we go, boys. This guy, I mean, a kingfish is capable of swallowing a bait up to a third of its body length. And while this is a big fat kingfish, the bait that I used was probably one third of its body length. Oh, there's a better one there.
The last one.
Nice work, Bev. Probably the best one on the jig for the day. A couple of quick picks of this guy. Sweet. Okay, buddy. He's a deep set fish, heavy fish. Might have to stay up all night again tonight and scoop up some flying fish.
The trip's off to a good start, but we've still got some boxes to tick for Bevan.
Oh yeah, boy!
Fortunately, the Ramfilly Banks turns it on for us and we get even more than we bargained for.
Oh yeah! Oh, I can't hold it. Might drop the camera down.
And we send a camera deeper than we ever have before to see what's lurking on the deep drop-offs of the Ramfilly Bank.
Uh-oh, it's being hit. Someone's trying to eat the camera.